Hello all. So I hope you're all doing absolutely well. A bit of a unique video that I'm doing it in this fashion for the first time from the confines of my own house. The reason I'm doing this is so something happened today which was quite a highly anticipated event in the motorcycling world, at least adventure motorcycles. So, out of the ether, out of the clouds, out of the heavens, the CB500X from Honda makes a quiet entry in the Big Wing website. Of course, all the typical motorcycling channels like Zigwheels, Power Drift, all of these guys tweeted about it that it's landed, and the biggest thing which made me go was, of course, the price. 6.87 lakhs ex showroom with a price of 8.56 lakhs in Bangalore on road, as confirmed by the Big Wing showroom in Bangalore. I'll let that sink in once more. A 500cc bike for 8.56 lakhs on road, Bangalore. So, let's analyze a couple of things here. No big event, no fanfare, no press release, no Honda top brass coming on the stage and ushering in the CB500X, none of that. They quietly slip it under the radar. Why? Is it a bit of shame for launching such a badly priced product on the Indian motorcycling community? I don't know. And I've made a set of notes on my little notepad here in front of me on the screen. I'm going to read out a few points for consideration. 500cc bike for 8.56 lakhs, that's the first one. A quiet under the radar launch, a sneaky launch. And go to the Big Wing website, the Indian website right now, and see the two models which they have. They are both yesteryear's models. One is the bland looking grey slash black color scheme, and the one is the regular red color scheme. And after you're done looking at them, go on over to Honda UK's official website, go to CB500X and look at the color schemes there. You will see three. One is the red, the normal red, which they're releasing in India, but with red accents, beautiful red accents in the subframe near the pillion. Beautiful. One is a beautiful black Honda CB500X with a red accent on the tank. And one which I actually had my eyes on is the white Honda CB500X, again with red accents on the tank and on the subframe near the pillion. So none of that is here in India. I just don't get it. Are we being dumped the 2019 stocks? Are we being dumped the 2020 stocks? I don't know. These are not 2021 stocks. If you don't believe my words, go have a look. The pricing, I will not even start to talk about the pricing. 8.56 lakhs, that's the same price for which you can get a brand new Versys 650 2021, a much more capable motorcycle, a much more respected, a much more revered, a much more venerated motorcycle in the motorcycling community, in the adventure and touring community. Trust me on this, much more powerful, much more load bearing. CB500X. Honda, I'm seriously not even sure what they were thinking. Is it arrogance? Is it like a bit of that surge pricing on Uber whenever you really badly want a cab and just because of the demand, the price just shoots up? Is it a bit of that going on here? I don't know. G310 GS was a lesson in arrogance when it launched 4.5 lakhs road on Bangalore for a 300cc bike which is manufactured in India by TVS. The public answered, the motorcycling community answered with their wallets. didn't sell many at all. They had to eat their humble pie and come down to the current price, which is I think 3.56 lakhs on road, Bangalore. A better proposition, still not a great bike in my opinion, but a better proposition financially. This is what should happen with the CB500X, one of my most favorite motorcycles, but the arrogance of the launch and its price is hard to fathom, is very hard to digest. Okay, let me tell you a little bit on its pricing in different countries. Have a listen. I did a quick snoop around on the internet. I managed to gather a few prices on the internet. Of course, a few of it may need to be, I may still need to find out if it's the exact price, but I think this is just a quick internet research. US, it's about 5.17 lakhs in INR. UK, it's about 6.25 lakhs in INR. Australia, it's about 5.62 lakhs INR. Thailand, 5.31 lakhs INR. Indonesia, again, very expensive, 8.22 lakhs. I don't know why. More of an anomaly. Germany, 5.96 lakhs. Canada, again, 4.65 lakhs. Seems a bit out of whack, but probably I'm not adding taxes or something here. I don't know. So the price averages between 5.5 to 6 lakhs, which is sort of par, okay? I would have grudgingly paid 6.5 lakhs for this bike in India. I would have even said, okay, screw everything. You want 7 lakhs on road Bangalore? Okay, done. Take it. 8.5 damn lakhs. Just not happening, guys. Just not happening. Okay, let me go back to my notepad. The most worthwhile alternative still remains, and I have a special respect for KTM today, the 390 Adventure, which is the bike with which this bike is compared the most. And if you look at Wiser Down's comparison of the CB500X versus the 390 Adventure, the 390 Adventure actually wins in the overall value proposition. Let's come to the accessories. At this price, the bike will probably sell a few bikes, if at all. The volume is not going to get the Indian accessories makers quite interested to make many accessories, if at all. Zana may do, probably a couple of others, but at this price and with the snob factor of owning this bike, people are going to mostly put in the international accessories like GV, like SW Motec, like Hepco Becker, like Touratech probably, I don't know. All of that is going to add on top of this 8.5 lakhs. Trust me, with all of the accessories which this bike must have, it's going to touch 10 lakhs. Okay, just for context, the center stand for a Versys costs about 23,000 or 24,000, SW Motec or Hepco Becker, that league of product. Crash guard, again, nothing less than 10-12,000 rupees at the bare minimum. No. It's actually more. Zana's versus crash guard itself is about 10,000 rupees. So it's going to be much more. So if you keep on adding more and more products, it's going to hit the 10 lakh mark very soon. There is one article which I read today. It's called The Curious Case of the Honda CBR650F Pricing. So CBR650F was similar. They launched it as a CKD. They priced very badly again, and once they started the local manufacture in India, in Manesar, it actually the pricing became a lot better, right? And now, since we're on the topic of CKD, the most everybody knows that it's because of the CKD, the completely knocked down condition in which this bike is imported and assembled in India, that this costs so much, because it's got a lot of custom element in it. Seriously, there is absolutely no prestige or snob factor associated with this particular CKD, because it's coming from Thailand. It's not coming from Japan. It's coming from Thailand. Make what you want to out of where it's coming from, but it's not from Japan. It's from Thailand. So now let's come down to a few conclusions. It's been quite a long video. Is it a bad motorcycle? No, hell no. It's a great motorcycle. It's an amazing motorcycle. It's an amazing product. It's a bad proposition. It's a bad value proposition. That's the thing to bear in mind. What are its competitors? The 390 Adventure, definitely in terms of capability, in terms of touring and off-roading, soft roading, whatever, 390 Adventure is more than capable. I own one. I've had absolutely no issues. And if you are anyway willing to pay that much amount of money, go for the Versys 650. Don't take my word for it. Do your research. Go read motorcycle forums in Germany, Australia, UK, US, the Western countries, Singapore, wherever. You will see what I mean. Versys is a tank. It's made to last. It's made to last. What is the way forward from here? What should happen now, in my opinion? What should happen is, we should let this first batch go the way of the dinosaur with our wallets, which will probably not happen. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if the whole lot just sells out like this. I don't know. I would personally wait for it to be localized and manufactured in India, in Manesar. I see that happening because they'll not be able to move critical volumes at this price for this bike. For this bike, it's not worth how much they are charging for it today. So the Manesar or wherever the production will happen, probably next year, probably the year after, who knows, but that will happen. I'll wait for it. I'm in no hurry. Or as in the case of the CBR650F, the initial launch, many of the dealers across India had to slash prices up to 1 lakh to sell all the unsold bikes because of the crazy pricing. That can happen with this, I don't know. So again, a very disappointing day for me, a legit CB500X fan, because I've been tracking this bike for almost 5-6 years now. Such a huge fan. Been watching all the videos since its early avatars, and yeah, I really hope to own one someday. I thought today was going to be the day till I saw the price. I still hope to in the next year or the year after, but not at this crazy price, guys. Not at this crazy price. Just my 2 cents. Thought of making a quick video just to share my disappointment and frustrations in a bit of a ranty video. Not much else left to say, really. So with this, I conclude my little tirade against unfortunately one of my favorite companies and one of my favorite motorcycle models, sadly. So yeah, that's what it comes down to. Thank you, and let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll try and answer as many comments or queries as I can. Thank you. Good night.